Now that we've registered our weather provider in the Android manifest, it's time to begin coding our weather provider. This is the final and most involved step in implementing our content provider. We'll be filling out these core content provider functions, except for onCreate, which we've already done for you. We've added an instance variable for our database helper. We initialize this in our onCreate function. We will use this database helper in most of the content provider methods. The first of the content provider methods that we will look at is getType. Implementing a functional version of getType isn't strictly necessary for our application, but it's a nice way to review what your eyes were planning to handle. We've partially filled out the getType function for you. We use the URI matcher we built earlier to match the given URI against the expressions we've compiled in. For each match, we return the types that we've defined in the weather contract. Remember that the key information that this conveys is whether the content URI will be returning a database cursor containing a single record, type item, or multiple records, type directory. Content providers can also be used to return other kinds of data than just database cursors. For example, if we wanted the content provider to return JPEG images for a content URI, we would have this function return the standard MIME type, image/JPEG. Let's uncomment the test get type test from within test provider. This will get us ready for the next coding exercise.